everyone, my name is Iris France. 我叫梁婉如。 Today we're going to talk about public goods. So what's the definition of a public good? A public good must satisfy two criteria. First, it must be non-rival, and second, it must be non-excludable. So what does it mean by rival? Rival is like this. If I consume it, that means you cannot consume it. And if you consume it, that means I cannot consume it. So think about, say, a can of Coke. If I drink it, that means you cannot drink it, and vice versa. So we know a Coke is a rival good. And the second is, what is excludable? Excludable is this: if you don't pay, then you don't get to enjoy the good. So we're able to exclude those who don't pay for the good from enjoying it. So a public good is a good that is non-rival and non-excludable. So let's take a look at the example. So we see the good can be rival and non-rival, and the good can also be excludable and non-excludable. So think about this. If a good is non-rival and non-excludable, meaning if it's non-rival, that means my enjoyment does not affect your enjoyment, and your enjoyment does not affect my enjoyment. We can both enjoy it without reducing the enjoyment. And non-excludable is this: if you don't pay, you can still enjoy it. That means you'll be able to free ride on the good. So think about public parks and national defense. These are the public goods because they are non-rival and non-excludable. So if it's a public park, that means when I'm, say, enjoying the park, I'm taking a walk, it doesn't affect, say, a mother bring her kid to the swing, right? We don't affect each other. So that's non-rival. And non-excludable is this: because it's a public park, so I don't have to pay, I can just enter it. Same as a mom with a kid. So you can see public parks, they are public goods. Same as national defense, as long as you're in the United States, you get to be protected by the national defense of the United States. Doesn't matter whether you pay for it or not, so this is non-excludable. And also it's non-rival because when I'm protected by this national defense, it doesn't affect your protection, the protection you receive from the United States national defense. So you can see public parks and national defense, these are public goods because it's non-rival and non-excludable. But the exact opposite will be private goods. So a private good will be both rival and excludable. So just think about the Coke I just mentioned. We know it is rival because I drink it, that means you cannot drink it. And it is also excludable because if you want to drink a can of Coke, you have to buy it. Either you have to buy it or your mom has to buy it. So someone will have to pay. So that good is a private good because it's both rival and excludable. Now we can see the goods that are in between. So let's first take a look at a club good. So a club good is non-rival and excludable. So think about the gym, it's kind of like a club. In order to enter, you have to pay for the membership. And once you enter, that's not rival. Why is that? Because in the big gym, usually there are, say, 10 treadmills, 20 ellipticals. So when you're using it, it does not affect another person, say, using the swimming pool, because you two are in different places. Or the museum. When you enter, you're looking at some painting. Some other people are also looking at some other paintings. You guys don't really affect each other's enjoyment. So the goods are non-rival but excludable. You have to pay, say, the ticket for the museum or the gym membership in order to enter. So we call that club goods. And the other corner is the good is rival but non-excludable. So what is that called? Well, the definition is called common pool resources. So one example is the office fridge. So you see usually in the office they have 20 employees, but they share a tiny fridge. So you can see the space is very limited, and anyone in this office can use this fridge. So you see you cannot exclude those who don't pay to enjoy the fridge because, well, you're in the office, you don't have to pay to use the fridge. But the space is very limited because usually the fridge is very small. So say I'm one of those 20 employees, and on Monday I came with a very large lunchbox, and I also have a dozen of Coke, and I'm going to squeeze that all in the fridge, and I occupy, say, a quarter or a half of the fridge space, then of course that's going to affect someone else's enjoyment of that fridge, because now the 19 other employees will have to use the tiny, tiny space, it's only half the size of the fridge. So you can see the good is rival. When I use the space, that means you cannot use it because this fridge is very tiny. And it's not excludable because, well, I don't have to pay and I can just use the fridge. So I hope this helps, and I'll see you next time.